Hey guys, so my topic and advice and tip for today is staff retention, right? And I bring this up because I know it's a topic and it's a struggle for providers and owners, not just in the city of Philadelphia, but just as a nationwide thing. And so my advice and I guess encouragement that I would give to my providers out there, if you are in the process or just continually struggling with staff retention, is that we have to go back to the basics. And when I say the basics, you have to remind yourself when you get in those moments, why did you start this childcare program? What was your initial mission? And what was your initial vision for the childcare program that you initially started? And I say that because we have to understand that when we're hiring people and we're bringing people into our childcare programs, that many times people come in, and I'm sure you guys can attest to this, they come in with their own mission and their own vision for your childcare program. And so it's okay, and I say this to providers, that when people leave your program or go somewhere else or they just quit, it's not always your fault. And as a provider, sometimes we just, you know, take it personal, like, dang, was it me? Was I not doing this right? Could I have done this better? But one of the things we have to learn in this childcare industry is that sometimes this is a stopover for people, right? And that the industry of childcare and just early childhood in general does not get nationally as much respect as it should. Because we're not babysitters. We're not babysitters. At least I know I'm not a babysitter. We're educators. And so understanding and wearing that hat as an educator and allowing your team and your staff to understand your level of expectation as that educator is a challenging job. And so if they don't understand their role as an educator, that you want better for your program, you want high quality for your program, it's okay to open up the door and let them off the bus. And I say a bus because when you initially start your childcare program, you're starting out at you're at the first bus stop. Like, you're just getting started, you're getting open, and now you're ready to go. But as you're in that industry and as you're in that position, you begin to grow and you begin to set different goals for your program, and the bus is making continuous stops. And so it's okay as a provider to let people off the bus that does not have the same mission and vision for your childcare program. And I say that because your childcare program is individual. It offers something unique amongst other different programs, or at least, you know, it should. And so it's okay to be confident in that was just not the right person for my program, and continue in this everlasting journey of bringing down the staff turnover retention in your program. But do not beat yourself up, and do not, you know, think that it's always you or your program, because many times people that come into the classroom don't realize the level of effort and energy that it takes to be a good, high quality program. No matter what it is, whether it's family based, whether it's infants, toddlers, school age, you know, it takes a great deal of energy to be an actual educator and not just a babysitter. So that's just my advice for providers out there, to do not lose the burning sensation. Do not lose that fire or flame. Just remember and go back to the original bus stop that you were at, and that's your mission and vision for your program. And if you see that people that's coming in your program does not have that same mission and vision, then you need to open up the bus and let them off. Because at the end of the day, it's going to cost you in the longer run to have those people in your program that don't have your best interest of your program at heart. So hopefully this is a good tip and tool for everyone. I have a happy Saturday.